सिन्धौ नैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञेयात्। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय हार्ट ओबिशियंस एंड द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय परमाराध्यतम गुरुपाद पद्मा नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णु पाद स्वत श्रीमद भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज। एंड टू से इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णु पाद स्वत श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज। माय डियर सन्यासी ब्रह्मचारी वैष्णव एंड व्यवस्थी यस्टरडे आज के वन डे चैतन्य महाप्रभु निराय पंडे इन हिज हाउस ही वाज चैंटिंग द नेम ऑफ गोपी 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 एंड सेम टाइम ए स्टूडेंट ऑफ एनी स्कूल ही केम टू मीट निराय पंडे। But he saw that he is chanting Gopi, 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 Gopi. He could not understand why. So he asked Mahaprabhu that why you are chanting Gopi, 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 Gopi? Why not Krishna? At that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in Gopi. He was thinking Krishna is very cruel. He can give up Srimati Radhika, even all gopis and even Radhika. So, like so cruel, I cannot chant Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. I will chant only Gopi, Gopi, Gopi. Then, when the student told him, why you are chanting Gopi, Gopi? You so chant Krishna. Then Mahaprabhu took a stick and ran after him to beat him. But he ran away very fast and went to his all colleagues and told, today I went to meet to see how is Nimai Pandit. I have heard so many wonderful things. But when I went to there and saw that he is chanting Gopi Gopi and I asked why not Krishna, why Gopi? Then he took a stick and ran after me to beat. But I ran very fast and anyhow I was saved. Then his all colleagues began to tell, oh, if this Sachi, son of Sachi can do this, he can beat any of us. We will also all beat him. Anyhow, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nimai Pandit heard this, that they want to also beat me. Then he began to think, I came क्या कफ निवारिते पिप्पली खंड कफ निवारिते आई कैन दैट फ्रॉम गोलोक वृंदावन दैट ऑल जीवस आर सफरिंग सो मच एंडलेस पेन ऑफ एंडलेस बर्थ एंड डेथ सो आई कैन टू गिव देम I came to help them to return back and to engage in Krishna services. But they want to beat me. Oh, I must take sannyas. And when I will take sannyas, then all will honor me as a sannyasi. So better it is. And then he made up his mind. That very soon I will take sannyas. Now he was doing kirtan with Srivasangar. And then one day he wanted that this is my last day. So he went to villagers. Where Gopalli was there. And he begged milk and also Loki. Loki meant?
Squash.
Loki. And then he met all his associates. Only Nityananda Prabhu. Chandrasekhar Acharya and few know they wanted that today in night he will give up his house, his mother, his wife, everything. So his mother also knew. Then when become evening he gave Loki and milk to mother. Mother, make me prepare lucky. Lucky means sweet lucky. Sweet part. Loki plus milk and boil it, give some sugar. Oh, it will be very, very delicious. Tasteful. Mother make it and give it to Shalagram Narayan. After offering she brought. Mahaprabhu took it very, very tastefully. In the night, Mahaprabhu decorated himself, Nimai Pandit. He never did so. And went to his Vishnupriya wife. And he decorated himself, gave garland, gave betel net in her mouth, and he was doing sringar. But Vishnupriya was not happy. She was thinking, if any light is to be put up. Listen. Then it does buck more fire. And after that, extinguish. Today I went to take bath in Ganges. And when I was going, oh, my. I had a huchut manaki.
I hurt my toe. Huh? I hurt my toe. I injured my
toe. In anywhere. And blood came. And when I was taking bath in Ganges, my nose ring at the time of marriage, it went to Ganges. I could not find, I searched so much. And then she came to Sachimaya and began to weep bitterly. What will happen today? I don't know. Maya told what became and he told this story. Oh, don't worry, everything will be all right. Now she was thinking, perhaps any very suffering is coming to me. Now he wanted to awake, not to sleep, but by Jogmaya influence, she was trying so much not to sleep, but yet she slept. And what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did? Oh, he became very, very cruel and saw once towards her and then at once gave up everything and he began to go. Mother Sachi was standing on the gate, but she was not weeping, not anything doing. She was like a statue. Why? For the separation mood of his son. And then Mahaprabhu did parikrama four times. And then he came out of the house and very near Ganges, very cold in the month of February in India, very cold. And Krishna, Krishna, Krishna telling, and he jumped in the Ganges. And from there, Katwa is about 10 or 12 miles, and he tar karke chali, or swimming, he went there. And there he went to Keshav Bharati. Keshav Bharati knew him, and there he wanted that, oh Gurudev, I'm giving my body to you, this everything, surrendering, and you should give me sannyas. Do you know what is sannyas? Especially sannyasi should know that this is mantra of gopi mantra. I'm taking the mood of gopi, I am gopi. And Krishna is my most beloved. Not a formality. Then he sent Mahaprabhu Nimai Pandit to a barber nearby city. Barber told, I cannot save you. Very beautiful curved hairs. And he began to weep. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nimai Pandit, then by his Jogmaya, he influenced that. And in the end of the day, oh, he saved him everything. And he went to Keshav Bharati. At that time, Nityananda Prabhu Chandrasekhar Acharya, Mukunda, five persons were there. And then he took sannyas. Now he became totally mad. Krishna, 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 Krishna. And he began to go towards Vrindavan. I will go Vrindavan. And where he was proceeding towards Vrindavan, but at once Nityananda Prabhu told, some boys were playing and some cows they were grazing. Nityanand Prabhu told the boys, cowherd boys, if that person is coming and he will ask you where, the way of Vrindavan, that then you should tell here, oh, near Ganges is there, Kalna, Shantipur. Oh, this side Kalna and this side Shantipur. And Nityananda Prabhu has sent a message to Advaita Acharya, I am very soon bringing Mahaprabhu here. And then, when he asked the cowherd boy, oh, can you show me the way of Vrindavan? Oh, Vrindavan is very nearer here, this side. And they diverted him towards Shantipur. He went to the Yamuna side and he said, oh, it is not Yamuna. This is not Vrindavan. Where I came? Here I am saying, on the other side, Shantipur, and here Advaita Acharya, Nityananda, and others. He told Advaita Acharya, are you in Vrindavan? He told, yes, I am in Vrindavan. This side river is Yamuna, that side Ganges. So please come with me. And then he took on the boat forcibly and went to Shantipur. In Shantipur, thousands and thousands of, millions of persons from here and there, from Mayapur, from Navadvip, from here and there, Shantipur, they came to see Mahaprabhu. Mother Sachi was also there. When now Sannyasi Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw his mother, he gave his head on her feet and told, mother, I have done wrong. I left you all. There is none to support you and to nourish you. If you will tell, again I will give up sannyas and I will return back to home. Then Sachimaya knew all the Shastra and etiquette, and he weeping told, no, no, my son, you should be in sannyas. And one thing more I want, that you should not go to Vrindavan. From here, nearer is Jagannath Puri. You should go there and you should live there. Sometimes you can come to take bath of Ganges. Sometimes so many devotees will go Jagannath Puri for Rath Jatra. And they will give your message to me. Then anyhow I can keep my life. Mahaprabhu told, yes, I will follow your order. She told Advaita Acharya, I want to beg you something. He told her, what you want to beg? I want to beg that till my son is here, I will cook my own hand and I will give prasadam to him. Advaita Acharya told, yes, you can do. And then thus, thousands and thousands of devotees came from here, there, from all sides. And Mahaprabhu, sometimes coming out of room and giving darshan, sometimes inside. If inside, then they all began to shout, oh, give darshan. In this way, how many days I don't remember. 10 days was here. In the meantime, Raghunath Das, a boy, a pilot of Bhavasindhu Kul, अंतरे कर निष्ठा बाह्य लोक व्यवहार अचिराते कृष्ण तुम्हार करी बेन उद्धार मरकट ना वैराग्य ना कर लोक देखाइया यथा योग्य विषय भोजन व्हाट मीनिंग दैट रघुनाथ डोंट बी रेस्टलेस रिटर्न बैक टू योर होम क्रमे क्रमे की ना ना फर्स्ट लाइन स्थिर हैया घरे जाओ ना हो बात डोंट बी मैड यू शुड रिटर्न बैक दैट टाइम हैज नॉट कम इट विल कम ऑटोमेटिकली यू विल बी मैच्योर फॉर गिविंग अप योर हाउस सो रिटर्न बैक एंड देन इनसाइड You should remember Krishna, and outside, you should behave your father, mother, your wife, and all others like others. Don't disclose I am detached from them. Show them outwardly, and always remember. Grama katha na sunibe na bolibe. Don't tell any. Mundane talk and don't hear also and there's Krishna very soon will deliver you and you can come to me and after 10 days Chaitanya Mahaprabhu proceeded towards Jagannath all bhakt began to weep in his separation and when he reached Khirchora Gopinath and he told to the Bhaksa and Nityananda Prabhu to what he told who will tell you yes
So, Guruve Gaura Chanda Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tada Bhaktaya Namo Namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sivasari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Panchatatvatpakam Krishnam Bhakta Rupa Surupakam Bhakta Avataram Bhakta Akyam Namami Bhakta Shaktikam So first, I give pranams thousands of times Lotus Feet of Sri Gurudev Chidani Sannyasis, Brahmacharis, Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, ladies and gentlemen. So we are hearing the nectarian pastimes of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu Sannyas. Actually, for the devotees of Navadvip, the pastimes of Gauranga is like a spear in the heart. Therefore, Narahari Chakravarti Thakur said, when that time will come, when Gaurahari will come back to Navadvip, and with his long hair, as a Grihastha, again we can do kirtan in the house of Srivas Thakur. Therefore, all the Vaishnavas were left weeping in Mayapur, and Mahaprabhu with just a few devotees, especially Sri Gadadha Pandit, Sri Mukunda, Sri Chandrasekhar, Sri Nityananda Prabhu, they left their Katwe where Mahaprabhu took sannyas from Keshav Bharati and came down towards Sri Jagannath Puri. Then they came to Khirchora Gopinath, Ramuna. So there is a very beautiful deity of Sri Krishna that was personally carved by the hands of Sri Bhagavan Ramachandra. Sita Devi had a desire to see Sri Krishna's Ram's form in Dwapara Yuga. Therefore Ram with his own hands, he carved that very attractive deity. So there Sri Nityananda Prabhu, he told the history of Khirchora Gopinath and all the Vaishnavas there were hearing. Sri Madhavendra Puri is described to be the Prem Ankur, the sprout of Braja Prem in this world. Sri Madhavendra Puri, he was from North India. Therefore he was always absorbed in Krishna Prem. It said he did not know if it was daytime or if it was night time. So he came to Brajamandal Parikram. So there his prem increased thousands of times. And there, near Govinda Kund, he was taking rest. Sri Madhavendra Puri, he never begged food or prasad from anyone. Whatever came automatically by the arrangement of Krishna, he would take that. So one night, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Ananya chinta yuktamam ye janu parupasate, tesham yukta biyuktanam yogekshemam yaham yaham. That person who exclusively thinks of me, whatever he needs, I give him, and whatever he has, I maintain. Therefore, Krishna himself came there with a pot of milk. Then Madhavendra Puri was very charmed. He could not understand this was Krishna. Because Vaishnav Seva gives such a happiness, even Krishna wants to taste that. Therefore, Krishna came in the disguised form. Otherwise, Madhavendra Puri, how he would accept the service from the hands of Krishna directly? That boy was very beautiful, and his voice was sweeter than millions of cuckoos. Then Madhavendra Puri was charmed. He asked, Oh Lala, where are you from? He said, I live here in Vrindavan. And my seva is that person who never asks for anything, I give them what they need. That's my duty in Vrindavan. He gave Madhavendra Puri that milk. And then he said, Baba, I have to go now and milk the cows, but I will come back to collect my pot. Sri Madhavendra Puri was waiting, but that boy never returned. Madhavendra Puri could not take his mind off the beauty of that boy. Then he was thinking, who is that boy that can attract my mind? In this world, nothing can attract me. So at night time, he had a dream, and that same boy came. Who am I? Ami naam Gopul, ami Govardhanadari. My name is Gopal, and I lift Govardhan. I am suffering a long time here, because when the Muslims attacked, the Pujari, he buried me under the ground. Therefore, many years I have not had anything to eat or drink. Therefore, in the morning, Madhavendra Puri woke full of ecstasy and he called the villagers. And they dug in the ground and they manifested the beautiful deity of Gopal. So there, Madhavendra Puri began the Seva Puja of Gopal. That village offered all their chapatis, rice, sabji, ghee, yogurt, mountains and mountains. And Madhavendra Puri, with his own hands, offered everything to Gopal. The next village heard, and the next day, that whole village offered the Mahotsav. So this is Anukut, the same festival we do at Gurudev in Govardhan. So gradually, so many cows, so much land was donated to Gopal. But Sri Madhavendra Puri had a dream, and Gopal said, Hari Baba, my body is burning, because for many years I could not have anything to eat or drink. Therefore, please go to South India and bring some sandalwood to paste on my body. That time, how old was Madhavendra Puri? More than 80 years old. Gurudev says, why the deity does not talk to us? Just imagine if it was winter time and very cold. Imagine if it was very cold and the deity appeared in our dream and said, Vijay, I am very cold and hungry. Please make me some puri. That time Vijay is thinking, Baba, it's very cold, how I can wake up? Also, I have many work to do tomorrow. It must be a bad dream. Because Krishna knows we would not follow his instruction, Krishna never gives us darshan, he never gives us order. We cannot follow even Gurudev's order in this world, then what will do if Krishna gives us any instruction? So Sri Madhavendra Puri, old age, he went alone and walked down to South India. Then he came to that same temple in Ramuna. And they offer a very famous type of kheer. Sri Amrit Kelly. So Madhavendra Puri was thinking, if I could taste that kheer, then I could know, I could make the same preparation for my deity in Vrindavan. Madhavendra Puri was not thinking to enjoy, he was thinking how to offer more service to Krishna. But then he thought, Dikka Hamaram, my mind is very wicked. That has not been offered to Krishna and I am thinking of eating it. Oh, I will punish my mouth. I will punish you, tongue. I will not give you anything. And Madhavendra Puri left and went to the solitary place to take rest. So the Pujari was sleeping and Gopinath appeared in the mind of the Pujari. You offered me 12 cups of kheer, but one cup of kheer I kept behind my cloth. In the market is one sannyasi, and my desire is you take that kheer for him and give it to him. His name is Madhavendra Puri. So the pujari woke up. What did he do? First he took bath. Because in pujari, there's so many rules and regulations. Nowadays we think, I'm such an elevated rustic Vaishnav, I don't have to follow any varnashram, I don't have to follow any rules, I don't have to follow anything because I'm a liberated Paramahamsa. But that pujari was on such a platform, Krishna is speaking directly before him, and what did he do? Got up, took bath. Then he went and took the kia, wiped the place, and he went to the market. Oh, has anybody seen Madhavendra Puri? He is the most fortunate person in the three worlds. Because Gopinath has stolen sweet rice for him. Therefore that deity got the name Kheer Chor Gopinath. Kheer means sweet rice. Chor means a thief. One, that Gopinath who steals sweet rice for his devotee. Therefore Krishna was thinking, I have so many bad names. If you go to Vrindavan, then what the Brijavasis will not say about Krishna. Then one more fault, no harm. So that time Madhavendra Puri, he took the sweet rice, he became full of bliss and ecstasy. And that clay pot, every day he would break a piece and eat it. So all the devotees were going down. That time Nityananda Prabhu, Mahaprabhu gave his danda for Jagadananda Pandit to hold. Then Jagadananda Pandit was holding the danda and the kamandalu of Mahaprabhu. So Mahaprabhu was going begging some vegetables to cook and rice. So Sri Nityananda Prabhu, he saw the danda and he became full of anger. Danda, how dare you? My Lord is worshipped by Paramahamsas and my Lord will have to spend the rest of his life carrying you. Therefore Nityananda became full of anger. Oh Danda, you are the cause of all the suffering of the Navadvipvasis. Because of you, Mother Sachi is weeping and Vishnu Priya is left alone. Therefore Sri Nityananda Prabhu, he took the danda and he broke it into three places. Then he became full of fear.
And he threw it out in Ganges.
He threw it in the Dandabhanga River. One river is there.
Now that river is Dandabhanga
River. So then he became afraid. Oh my God, what have I done now? Then Mahaprabhu came back and he saw the broken kamandalu and he asked, Jagadananda, where's my danda? I gave it to you. Then Jagadananda was afraid. You ask your tripad, Nityananda, what happened to the danda? Then Nityananda said, who made the danda? He broke the danda. No? Then Nityananda also said, you broke it. You are unconscious, you fell on your own danda, and you broke the danda. I had nothing to do with this. Then Mahaprabhu became angry. You don't know the danda. The danda is the residing place of the 33 million demigods. Is directly Vishnu himself, and you threw it up and gave it up. What type of Vaishnava are you? All you devotees are just disturbing me. Therefore you go ahead and I will come after, or I will go ahead and you will come after. Then the Vaishnava said, oh Lord, you go to Jagannath Puri and we will follow from behind.
Then Mahaprabhu proceeded toward Jagannath Puri. And he came to Sakshi Gopal. And the story of Sakshi Gopal, Rasananda Prabhu will speak.
I don't know English. So Gurudev, give me a time. Firstly, give me order to me. Oh my Jnanati Viram Jasya, Jnananjana Salakaya, चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय इष्टदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद बोलो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे फास्ट माय एफर्ट माय ओबेंसेस माय गुरुदेव नित्यलीला प्रविष्णु विष्णुपाद अष्टोदर सदा श्री श्री श्रीमद भक्ति श्री रूप सिद्धांत गोस्वामी महाराज आफ्टर माय सेम ओवेंसेस आई अफर्ड माय शिक्षा गुरुदेव పరిప్రాజక ఆచార్య జితేంద్రి స్వామి శ్రీ శ్రీమద్ భక్తి వేదాంత నారాయణ గోస్వామి మహారాజ్ అల్ వైష్ణవి అండ్ వైష్ణవ వన్ సెవెన్ టై టూ బ్రాహ్మణ్ వన్ ఏ ఓల్డ్ బ్రాహ్మణ్ అండ్ వన్ ఏ యంగ్ బ్రాహ్మణ్ దే ఆర్ వెయింట్ ఫర్ సమ్ పిల్గ్రిమ్ ప్లేస్ అండ్ వెన్ దే ఆర్ కమ్ టు బృందావన్ స్టే దే ఆర్ వన్ ఏ గోపాల్ టెంపుల్ when they are stay there who is the very old brahman now he is so happy why he is very so old and who is a young brahman he do so much help to him that is pilgrim travel so without this young brahman he cannot do this pilgrim nath jatra pilgrim travel so now he becomes so happy now this friend of gopal this old brahman he told this young brahman bolo oh young brahman you are my look you are as my son so I am so happy to you know bidai to you I cannot do travel this pilgrim place so I am happy but I want to give something to you bolo what well I have a one very beautiful young girl so her daughter So when I will return, I want my daughter give to you with you marriage. Then this young Brahman told, this is impossible. Well, why? Well, even you are both is the Brahman, but you are very highest Brahman, I am very lowest Brahman. But this thing you can told, but your family cannot accept this thing. Well, this is my daughter. My daughter, so I am do bhav I gave to you my daughter to you well if you return and your family this thing not don't accept and then what happened well I am in this front of this gopal I am take this bhav I gave my daughter to you but when they are both in the return one day this old brahman he calling this whole family this son and this wife this daughter and he tell this all past time then this family become very angry this son well how is the possible well Indian tradition is the this rule is the so hard even they are both is the brahman then this son told if you gave our sister to this brahman then you are drink this poison you can leave this body well you don't then this old brahman told but I am witnessed in front of this gopal then what happened well gopal he the stone he did not come to hear this witness then well pitaji you don't worry if this young brahman came here you make some excuse I am what I gave promise to you I am don't know and I am forget I am don't know so that then what can I do you can do you don't worry after some days the young brahman think oh this old brahman he promise he must give her daughter to me but now he is tough he don't tell anything now then one day this young brahman came this old brahman house well then he told you promise you gave your daughter to me but now why you stop why did not tell anything then this old brahman he by heart he want gave her daughter to him but by force of this family now he also make some excuse well what I before told you I forget I don't know then this sir they are bringing one stick well nonsense idiot young brahman when you go to pilgrim journey that time my father have so much money he stolen all money now you want marriage to our sister sister then is bring stick I want to beat him now he's the run away now this young brahmani calling hall whole villagers and they are doing a meeting then meeting then when come villagers well you have any witness well yes This is the friend of Gopal, he promised. Then this son stole, yes, he go and bring this Gopal. If this Gopal he give witness, then you can give our debtor to you. Then no, this Gopal is the stone. He not, don't telling anything. Now this young Brahman is the devotee. He have full faith, must this Gopal he come to here and give this witness. Now this young Brahman came to Vrindavan. This Gopal's friend of this Gopal, hello Gopal, your friend, this old Brahman, witness, he gave her daughter to me. Now when you return, now he's the, kya bolte, and promise, break his promise. So necessary, you can came with me, the Jagannath Puri, by this your own mouth, you gave witness. Now this Gopal now speaking. Well, how is the possible? I heard any date walking? Are you heard any date is the walk, any date? I am big stone, how possible I can go there? Well, if cannot he go, how you speak? When you speak, you must also walk with me. Must you come with me? Then he is the complete, he is the devotee. He completely, he is the, what tell you? He completely controlled by this love, affection. Well, yes, I can go. But at Puri, Vrindavan to Jagannath Puri, so long distance. If you walk, minimum 1 month necessary. If you 1 month, you walk there.
Not Jagannath Puri, Vidyanagar.
Vijayanagara, this Vidyanagar is so long distance. Well, yes, I can walk, but very long distance. You can do one thing, 1 kilo, you know, rice, you make khichdi. And offer to me, I ate, then I can walk. Then he make the 1 kilo khichdi, and he offered, and Krishna, he all khichdi with the ate. And now, telling yes, I can follow to you, but one thing, you don't, kya apne piche ghum kar nahi dekha, you don't look behind. If you look behind, then I can stand. Then stand. Then this young Brahman he told, if you don't come, what happening? Well, I am came. Well, how can I understand you follow to me? Well, one thing you do, my leg, you know, kya bando. I have uncle well. When I walking, he is the some nice, you know. He can become some nice, he can understand I am following you, walking behind you. Well, yes, now this young Brahman is the walking, Krishna also follow to him. And this uncle was nice, also come very nicely. And when he came before Vidyanagar, now they are so sand there. Now Krishna's foot is the go inside of the sand. Now this uncle was nice, now stuff. Now young Brahman think, well, why stop this uncle well? If Krishna don't came, then what can I tell this villager and king? Then he think, if I turn my face, if I look to Krishna, very close to Vidyanagar, then I can bring to everybody here. Now just he turn this face, when he saw like this, now Krishna is the stand there. Krishna told, before I told you, don't look in behind, I cannot walk now. Now bring to everybody here. Now this Brahman is the coming. He told her whole villagers and king and queen. Now well, Gopal he came from to Jagannath Vrindavan to here. And when all villagers, king and minister, this queen heard, Gopal by walking came Vrindavan to Jagannath Puri Vidyanagar, everyone became very surprised. Now whole villagers, king, minister, queen, everybody there came. Krishna by walk he came to here. When there came, really there saw Krishna is the came here. Everybody became very surprised. Now this by own mouth, Krishna he told, well, yes, this old Brahman, friend of me, he take a bow. He gave her daughter to this young Brahman. But force of this family, now he don't want to give her daughter. This is the truth. Everybody became very surprised. And this queen, when he said this Gopal is the very beautiful, now she is very good devotee. Now she think, oh, I am one a diamond nose ring. I want to put Krishna's nose. But how is the possible? He is a stone. Maybe he have no nose, any hole. When this queen return and sleep, this Gopal now he gave night time, he gave dream. Well, oh queen, you want give me your diamond nose ring? But you think my nose no any hole? Well, yes, still my nose one hole. When I am childhood, mother Jasoda, he put one hole my nose. Did one hole my nose. Still now, this hole still my nose now. If you nicely you saw, you can saw this thing. Queen is become very surprised. Many times he told this king, hello king, when I saw this Gopal, I think I have one diamond nose ring and I want to offer to Krishna. Well, night time Krishna he gave dream to me. This nose has one hole. When he childhood mother Jasoda, he did one hole. Still now this hole, this nose. Raj king also became very surprised. Now both bring this diamond nose ring. Real when they are saw Krishna nose has one hole. And then mother, then queen, he offered to Krishna. This way, Krishna, he came to Vrindavan to Vidyanagar. So this name is the Sakhi Gopal. Sakhi meaning witness. This meaning is the, you know, somebody telling Krishna don't tell talking, Krishna don't walking, Krishna don't eating, Krishna don't sleeping. So our one Hindi bhajan, they are telling, koi kehte hai bhagwan sote nahi maiya jasoda jaise tum sulate nahi koi kehte hai bhagwan aate nahi draupadi jaise tum bulate nahi koi kehte hai bhagwan khate nahi sabari jaise tum khilate nahi. Meaning of this kirtan, somebody thinking, oh Krishna don't sleep. Then this devotee tell, yeah Krishna must sleep. But necessarily you have like this Jasoda mood. If mood of Jasoda, how Jasoda when in the Krishna when sleep, how Jasoda sulate, matlab? Make sleeping, only make sleep, Jasoda only make sleep to Krishna. Somebody telling Krishna is the not coming, telling, next you calling like this Draupadi. When Draupadi calling to Krishna, call to Krishna, that time Krishna is the appear and give this cloth. Somebody telling Krishna is the don't eat. Well, eat, you make like this Sabari. When Sabari, when Ram came to Sabari's house, that time Sabari's remnant, Ramchandra ate. Himself he ate. So necessary you have some love affection. Your in heart is the love affection, like this Sanatana Goswami, when he offered without salty, wrote chapati, that time Krishna accept this thing. Yes. So Krishna only he controlled by love affection. If you are love affection, you are doing bhajan and kirtan, Krishna also one day he get prem to us.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
When Nityananda Prabhu, broke the danda of Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu became some angry and then told them, you all should go first to Jagannath, either I will go first, I cannot go with you. Always making problem for me. Then they told Prabhu, you should go alone, we will come later on. Then Mahaprabhu, when come to Dandabhanga, Atharanala, he did pranam and he became in mood, bhava
And then he began to run towards Jagannath Dev. When he entered the Jagannath temple and he saw Jagannath, he saw not Baladev and Subhadra, and playing on flute, O Brajendranandan, Tumar Bina Phate Mor Pran, Mor Prananath Murali Badan, Kaha Jaun, Kaha Paun Murali Badan. O my dear flute wala, where you are? After long time I have met you. Without your separation, my heart is broken. And thus he ran madly to embrace Jagannath Dev. When he reached nearby, the guards stopped him and they began to beat with a stick, not hit. So, and there, when they stopped, he became faint totally, no sense at all. Then the guards began tried to beat him and take him out of temple. But in the meantime, Sarvam Bhattacharya, he was Brihaspati, he came and saw. Oh, so symptoms of praying are seen in him. Mahabhav, it is not seen any human being, but I am seeing, and all the symptoms are like God, Supreme Lord. Who is he? He could not decide, but anyhow, he told his servants that take him in this stage to my house and there he will come incense. Then he went there. After that, Nityananda Prabhu and others, that party, they came and searching Mahaprabhu, they did not saw him. And then someone talking each other, oh, that sannyasi was very high class of sannyasi. And he became faint and he ran away to embrace Jagannath. Hearing this, they decided, no, he is in Sarvam house, and then all went there. And they began, when they saw Mahaprabhu, they began to do kirtan around him. Hearing kirtan, or some breath came gradually. And then Sarvam Bhattacharya told to Gopinath Acharya, brother-in-law Sarvam, he was inhabitant of first Navadvip. So he knew about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He knew all everything. So one day Sarvam told, I want to teach that boy sannyasi Vedanta, and thus he can save his sannyas. Otherwise he is so beautiful young, he cannot save his young, he may fall down. Then Gopinathacharya told, though you are so intelligent and learned person, but you don't know anything. Oh, he is not a ordinary boy and sannyasi. He is himself Avatari Krishna. He has come to fulfill his desire. Sarvam Bhattacharya told, oh, in this Kali Yuga, no avatar. No incarnation of Krishna. So how he can be? Oh, you cannot decide by intelligence. Shastra has told, but you don't know the meaning. He is not simply incarnation of Krishna, but himself Krishna, Avatari Krishna. He told, his disciples told Sarvam Bhattacharya. How do you know? Oh, to whom he has merciful to them, and he will mercifully inspire that I am Supreme Lord, then anyone can. One sloka of Upanishad. Naam atma pravachanena labdha na medhaya na cha bahuna jam eva esa pedite tem eva labdha. To whom I merciful, oh, I myself revel with them. So, you cannot know. One day it will come. And you will see. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to Sarvam Bhattacharya and Bal Sanyasi, I cannot save my sannyas. So please, you are like my father and like my guru. You should teach me Vedanta. I will hear. And then he began to hear. And what became? Suddhadvaiti Maharaj will try to tell. Very good arguments, interesting, and he got cut all the arguments of Mayabad and established Krishna, beautiful, sweet, pastimes, name, gun, roop, lila.
Oma jnanta milandasya gyananjana shalake shakshur mitamirati smaya shri gurave namah. So we just heard from the lotus master Srila Gurudev how Sarvam Bhattacharya, when he saw that Mahaprabhu